Welcome to Python series. In this video, we are going to learn about dictionaries. In our last video, we have learned about creating lists and tuples. So these were comma separated values. And in the dictionary, we have the values which are mapped. So that is the difference. The list have comma separated values, but in our dictionary, the values will be mapped in a key and value pair. So let us see how we can simply create a dictionary. So for this video, let us suppose we have to create a list that contains the types of software and their names. So we take a name SW for software. And the second difference that you will see from list and tuple that we are going to use the curly brackets. Not the simple parentheses, not the square brackets, but dictionary use these curly brackets. So let us create the key value pair. First of all, see the syntax. The key will be the first value and the value will be separated by a colon symbol. Okay, so you have to input two things, the key and the value, and the whole thing will be separated by comma in case you have multiple key value pairs. So for example, if you have three pairs, so let me just copy it. Okay, so you will have three key value pairs separated by a comma. So let us try writing an actual dictionary. So for example, you have a name OS as the key. So this is our key, which stands for operating system, and the value is whichever operating system you are using. Let's say I'm using Windows 10. So this is our first key and value pair, where the key is OS and the value is Windows 10. Let's write another key value pair, AV, antivirus. So which antivirus you are using? I'm using Note 32, it's my favorite. So now we have two key value pairs. Let's write another one. Let's say which browser is your favorite. Let's say Firefox. Okay, so our dictionary is complete, which has three key value pairs. As you can see, they are separated by a comma. The first thing is the key, the second is the actual value. So what else we can do with the dictionary? Which text is acceptable here, which is not? You can write any string, you can write any number, and even you can write a tuple here. The thing is that you should not be able to change it. So that is the reason we are not able to write a list here, because if you remember, list is mutable, list can be changed anytime, and we don't want this to happen with our key. The key should remain stable, it should not change. So we can use a string, we can use a number, and we can use a tuple here. So we'll try that in a few moment. Let us try to print some values out of this dictionary. Let's see how we can do it. So of course we will use our print command and our dictionary name, which is SW, and we can supply any key name here which will print our value. So if we want to print our operating system, the key is OS. Okay, so print SW dictionary and the key name. Let's run the program, and we are getting the value Windows 10, which is the value of the key OS. Let's change it to browser, and we should get Firefox, and we are getting Firefox. So as I said that you can use tuple as a key. So let's try changing this string and write a tuple here. We use simple brackets. So let's supply two values, browser, and We sometimes also call it explorer. I'm just trying to be meaningful. Of course, you can use any string here, any values, okay, any number of values. And let's try to run this program and change this browser written here, which was our previous key, to the newly added tuple. Okay. So now in our print command, we have our dictionary name and we are supplying the key, which is the tuple, and we should get Firefox in the output. Let's run the program and we are getting Firefox. And one more thing, let's try changing this tuple into a list by simply changing the type of bracket, and we should get an error here because the list is mutable and we cannot use that. And as expected, it is saying type error, unhashable type list. Okay, so you have seen the use of dictionary, how we can create the dictionary using a simple key and value pair. Each pair is separated by a comma, and you can use string, you can use numbers, and you can use a tuple in the place of tuple as a key. So that is all for this video. Hope you have enjoyed learning. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.